Welcome, my fellow explorers and lovers of science. Today, I invite you to join me on a fascinating journey not just to see gold, but to understand how it can be carefully, patiently, and intelligently extracted from complex rocks that hold not only gold, but other valuable metals like iridium, cobalt, and nickel. We're not going to use cyanide, mercury, or any other harmful or dangerous shortcuts. Instead, we'll rely on solid chemistry, real lab work, and safe materials. This is not just about gold, it's about learning, experimenting, and mastering the process. You see, many rocks found in nature, especially black sands, volcanic materials, ore, or veins contain a complex mix of metals. While most people think only of gold, they often overlook hidden treasures like iridium, one of the rarest elements on Earth, or cobalt and nickel, essential for modern batteries and electronics. In this detailed, step-by-step experiment, I'll guide you through every phase, from crushing the raw rock into powder, separating the heavy minerals using gravity, roasting the concentrate to prepare it for chemical treatment, and then dissolving away the unwanted metals to isolate gold and iridium. You'll see everything, hear my reasoning at each step, and understand why we do what we do, not just how. Whether you're a hobbyist, a student, or simply curious about how metals are separated in real life, you'll find value here. So grab your notebook, maybe even your own sample of rock, and follow along. By the end of this video, you won't just witness the recovery of gold, you'll understand the science behind it. Let's begin. This is the type of rock we'll be working on today. At first glance, it might look like an ordinary piece of stone, dark, rough, and heavy, but if you look closer, you'll notice some unusual features: its weight, its metallic shine in certain areas, and the presence of fine grains that suggest it's much more than just a rock. This specimen is what we call a polymetallic, or a rock that contains multiple valuable metals locked inside. Through experience, testing, and visual inspection, we can tell that it's rich in several heavy metals, most notably gold, iridium, cobalt, and nickel. Each of these elements has unique properties, and they all behave differently under heat, acid, and physical separation processes. Gold, for instance, is soft, malleable, and dense. It's often found in its native metallic form. Iridium, on the other hand, is one of the densest and most corrosion-resistant elements known to man. Cobalt and nickel are lighter but still valuable, often found as sulfides or oxides mixed into the mineral matrix. But before we think about extracting anything, we need to take a crucial first step. We need to break the rock down physically and mentally. Physically, it will crush and grind it into a fine powder, so the individual particles of metal are freed from the surrounding material. Mentally, we need to understand what we're dealing with, the structure, the composition, and how these elements are bonded within the rock. Only when we understand the material can we choose the right methods to separate each metal carefully and efficiently. So, let's get started with that first and very important phase, breaking the rock down to unlock its hidden treasures. Our first step in this journey of extraction is a very physical and essential one, crushing the rock into a fine, consistent powder. This may seem like a simple mechanical task, but it's actually one of the most important steps in the entire process. Why? Because within this rock, the valuable metals gold, iridium, cobalt, and nickel are not sitting loosely on the surface. They're locked tightly inside a dense, complex matrix of minerals, like tiny prisoners trapped within stone. In order to free them, we must reduce the rock into particles small enough to allow gravity, chemicals, and heat to interact directly with the metal content. We start by using a hammer or a mechanical jaw crusher to break the larger chunks into smaller gravel-sized pieces. Then, we continue refining it with a ball mill, a grinder, or even a hand mortar and pestle, until the material becomes as fine as sand or even finer. The finer the powder, the better our chances of separating and recovering the metals efficiently in the later steps. It's all about increasing surface area and exposing every hidden fragment of gold or iridium to the processes that follow. This stage also gives us our first physical connection with the ore. As you crush, you'll feel the resistance of the rock, hear the difference in texture, and begin to notice small changes in color or density that hint at the presence of metals. It's dusty, it's noisy, and it can be tiring, but it's absolutely necessary. This is where our real work begins. From this powder, we will rebuild value, step by step. We'll now move on to the next critical phase of our process, gravity separation. This technique is based on one of the oldest and most reliable principles in mineral extraction: density. Every material has a specific density, or what we commonly call heaviness. Gold and iridium are among the heaviest natural elements known to man. When compared to the lighter minerals that make up most of the rock, like quartz, feldspar, or clay, the difference in weight is dramatic. And that difference is exactly what we'll use to our advantage. In this step, we'll use water as a medium and tools like a gold pan, a sluice, or even a shaking table to separate the heavier particles from the lighter waste. As we agitate the powdered ore in water, the lighter materials will stay suspended or float away, while the heavier particles, our precious metals, will sink quickly and settle at the bottom. This is where your focus and patience matter most. You must observe the way the particles move. You'll start to notice that the black sands and dense spakes settle differently. They resist the flow, they cling to the bottom, and they sparkle under the light. Those are your indicators: gold, iridium, and possibly platinum group minerals. What we're doing here is called concentration. We're concentrating the most valuable elements into a smaller amount of material that we'll treat chemically in the next steps. It's like picking the ripest fruits from a large tree, leaving behind the leaves and stems. The more carefully we do this, the purer our final result will be. So take your time, control the water flow, and pay close attention. Nature is giving us clues, you just have to know how to read them. Now that we've concentrated the heavy minerals using gravity, it's time to move to a more advanced and transformative step: roasting. This is the phase where we take our collected concentrate, now rich in gold, iridium, and possibly sulfide compounds of cobalt and nickel, and subject it to high heat. But why do we do this? Many of the metals we want to separate, especially cobalt and nickel, are not present as pure metal, but rather as sulfide minerals. That means they are chemically bonded with sulfur in solid form, creating stubborn compounds that are difficult to dissolve or separate directly. Roasting is how we begin to break those bonds. By carefully heating the concentrate in open air, usually on a metal plate or inside a crucible, we allow oxygen to react with the sulfur, creating sulfur dioxide gas and leaving behind metal oxides or even free metal particles. The material will slowly change color as the chemical structure transforms, often from a dark, oily black to a reddish or gray tone. This step must be done slowly and safely. The temperature needs to be high enough, typically above 500 degrees Celsius, but not so hot that we risk melting the valuable metals or releasing harmful fumes too quickly. You'll want good ventilation or an outdoor workspace, and safety equipment like gloves and eye protection is absolutely necessary. You may notice a faint smell like burning matches, that sulfur dioxide being released. That's a sign the roasting is working. As the sulfur burns off, we're freeing cobalt and nickel for the next step, where they'll be dissolved using acid, while gold and iridium remain solid and unaffected by this roasting process. Roasting is both a physical and chemical shift, turning our raw mineral material into something more reactive, more accessible, and more ready for precise separation. In a way, we are unlocking the second layer of the ore's secret, and the results will show in the next phase acid leaching. To be continued.